detention several times. And he couldn't because he said, "Oh, it's like fire in my bones, God."
Hold on.
And earlier, I was reading from Psalms 22 this morning when I was in prayer for this campus. A lot of times, I travel America and Europe, and a lot of times people ask me, "Do you have a word for your school, for this school? Do you have a word?" I do have a word from God for this campus, and it's a hard word, but God is sick of the God mockers. God is sick and tired of those that mock him. And I have lots of scriptures on those that mock God. And the word of God says God is not mocked. Whatsoever you sow, you'll reap. But the scripture God gave me today to proclaim over your school is found in Psalms 22 and Matthew 27. I'm going to go ahead and read that now. Psalms 22:7 says, "And they that see me laugh me to scorn, they shoot at the lip, they shake their head." Matthew 27:39, "And they pass by, revile him, wagging their head." That's exactly what happened to Jesus as he was being led like a lamb to the slaughter. People mocked him, shaking their head, and then saying, mocking things to Jesus. The most loving man that ever lived was mocked, and people shaking their head at him. So those of you that are trying so hard to be super love person of the year, if you stand for Christ, people are going to shake their head and they're going to mock you too. The Bible says all those that live godly shall suffer persecution. Jesus' disciples were persecuted. They were killed, many of them. Acts 7, Stephen was stoned to death. It's part of the package. "You will be hated," Jesus said, "because he is hated." So those of you that feel like that you are a born-again Christian, and the reason I say feel is because this generation goes on a lot of feelings. A lot of people say, "I feel God's just not like that." Or, "I feel God just wouldn't care about that." Now, a lot of people are going on feelings versus the Word of God. just like the days of Noah. Well, if we knew that Jesus said he will come back just like the days of Noah, perhaps we should study what was going on in the days of Noah. What was going on? Well, we know there was a flood. We know there was a rainbow. We know, well, I know, maybe you don't. We know that only 8 people were spared from the wrath of God. Okay, so knowing that fact, we should still say, why? You know, children are always, why this, mommy? Why this? Why, why? We should be like that about Judgment Day. We should be that way about God. But we don't ask why anymore. We just say, eh, I don't care about God. Screw him. And I've heard people talk like that on this campus. Very, very potty mouth. Many students at this campus have been here 8 days. Many students have horrible potty mouths. And God wants to set you free. God wants to bring revival. God wants to seek and to save that which is lost. God doesn't want anybody from this campus to be thrown into the lake of fire. The gospel is for everybody. The gospel was given so that you could have a chance to choose him. He's such a great, great God, a lover of souls.